I'm gonna warn y'all, there's gonna be so much fangirling in this video. It's gonna get intense. If a Well, this review's starting out pleasant. If a novel gets my brain happy and my lady pants horny, then it's a unicorn that poops diamonds and world peace. So we're talking about vampire romances. But unlike other fluff puffs that I could mention,
no judgment,
this one actually does the good. Granted, I was the derp derp who thought it wouldn't, but hello, I was wrong. This story does the Bowser and Princess Peach stick because Mr. Hero Vamp snatches Miss Heroine Human and takes her back to his lair. But unlike Princess Peach, Nicole kicks ass. She is a smart, kind of traumatized scientist who is, whoops, related to the CEO of Bad Guys Incorporated. Now our pointy teeth sex god hero is on a mission to save his clan, but to do it, he needs the chick who kind of enslaved his dead wifey. And if after all of that you are still a no-go on this thing, then that's all I got. Cause this book's world building is everything. It's so interesting because in this universe, vampires don't exist in secret and humans crap all over them. I also really enjoyed the scientific slant that this novel takes towards vampirism. So as a result, we actually end up getting a very intelligent heroine because she's a scientist and she's incorporated into the world and she's amazing.
And it makes me love her so much.
Hound by Night delivers on a lot of things, including a great secondary cast. The characters that populate our hero's clan are witty and fun. For instance, there is Sarcastic Mime with his titanium vamp teeth. There's Hunter, the video game playing clan leader. Grant, the scientist sweetheart nerd. Lucy, the endearing, developmentally challenged, candy-loving vamp teen. Aelin, the physically handicapped vampire with a heart of gold, and just so many more. All of those precious babies won my heart, but first prize goes to Nicole. Dude, this girl is awesome. Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. In fact, let's try sex again. Maybe my magic vagina will cure you of all the traumatic acts my family has inflicted on you.
Can't breathe from the funnies.
Our female lead was hilarious and intelligent and like human, as in somebody with layers, complexity, and flaws. She is a damaged woman, but she's strong. She stands up to people and knows when to shut up.
I love her.
But more on my heart boner for Nicole later, because now we gotta talk about that hero. Aside from the book being smut-tastically smexy, aside from a romance that will viscerally rip your feels out of you, aside from all the wonderful plot and story, there's Riker. This dude comes equipped with a very tragic past, but he's not a big emo face about it. Yeah, he's sad and he is so not over his man pain. But Riker doesn't spend his time sipping a glass of B positive staring out a rain-soaked window.
Thank you, Jesus.
His military ass gets shit done despite his big man feels he's totin'. The characters rock, the hero rocks, the heroine rocks, but that plot rocks too. Our internal conflict is Riker and Nicole untangling their mutual pasts while trying to cope with their new wounds and old. And the external conflicts are battle scenes, black op missions, and even science. So if you enjoy kinetic, dynamic, and character-driven stories, this is your jelly jam. It's fun, it's creative, and it's, oh my god, so well written. I mean, Bound by Night is so perfectly paced that there are no dry spots. And yes, my brain did just make that dirty. In my defense though, Riker and Nicole have some hot smexy times together, so blame them and not me. I mean guys, vampire teeth did naughty naughty things on the Lady Playtime Place. And I, unabashed kinky bitch that I am, thoroughly approve. In all seriousness though, the book is top shelf and I can't recommend it enough. Frankly, I lack any real criticism to lodge against it. Yeah, there's a few unnecessary or rushed plot points here and there, but it's like 2 degrees from perfect. So I stand by my recommendation. Because in this book, the heroine gets to be the hero. So who cares? Seriously, Nicole rescues Riker's distressed ass from the super duper bad guy vamps. And when it was her turn to get kidnapped, she's the one who instigates her own rescue. I love that hard. I love that so hard. Some might also say that the OTP opened up a little bit quick after just 100 pages of interaction, but considering their mutually shared past, I can't throw a lot of shade. So it didn't really bother me. This is just a really good book. This thing is a crack read, so just please shut me up and go read it. Like seriously, please shut me up and go read it. No, really, shut me up. I know that over the last couple of years, vampire romances and paranormal romances in general have kind of nosedived in popularity, but I really hope they make a resurgence because they are my favorite. That's not true. Anything with romance is my favorite. I know it was an oversaturated market, and I know that Twilight was definitely one of the reasons that happened. Larissa Iohn, please don't abandon this series! You've got like, what, 2, maybe 3 books in this? I know you're working on the next generation of Demonica stories, but don't forget about this! If you have read this book, or if you've read anything by Larissa Iohn, tell me so we can fangirl together! I also want to apologize, guys, if this review kind of crapped out at the end. There was storm warnings, somebody washing their car, people riding mopeds, outdoor stray animal sounds, my cat sneezing, children screaming, my phone went off, the camera died, I thought I was recording and I wasn't recording, and then that got me flustered and just, oh! I am the worst reviewer ever. So I'm sorry. And thank you for being here and not throwing tomatoes at your television. Why did I say television? What?
I need to shut up. Go away and stop being an idiot.